There's a peace I've come to know. Though my heart and flesh may fail, there's an anchor for my soul. I can say it is well.
Well, good morning and welcome to the Chester ARP Church Devotional Podcast again on this Tuesday, July the 7th. Thanks for being with us. We're going to turn our attention to Psalm 71, and Psalm 71 is one of the more lengthy psalms in this particular section with its 24 verses. I remember when I was just getting started on my own. I was out of college and out of seminary, and I'd taken the pastorate here in Chester. And I remember one day my dad called and asked me if I needed something, and I said, no, I'm okay, thanks, though. And then he called and asked me if I needed something else, and I said, no, I'm okay. And this went on for some time, and being the young 25, 26-year-old, I got a little frustrated with him. And I said, please stop calling me. I'm a grown man. I've got a job. I've got a responsibility. I'm capable of taking care of myself. And I remember my dad saying to me then, son, you don't understand it now, but when you become a father, you'll recognize that once you have children, they are your children until they are no longer your children, either until you go to be with the Lord or the Lord calls them home. And so I'm always going to be concerned with you. I'm always going to be there to care for you, and I'm always going to be there to support and to be your number one fan, but also to provide, if I can, any help that you may need. Now that I have my own children, I begin to understand that a little bit better. But Psalm 71, I think, is a psalm that really shows us just how much God cares about us. And how much not only does he care about us, but he is there for us and provides for his people and makes preparations for them and works in their lives and takes good care of them all of their lives from the time of their birth to the time of their death. And that every point of the along the way is a life and opportunity for the people of God to testify to the infinite and wonderful goodness of our God in heaven. And so Psalm 71 is a prayer when David says, forsake me not when my strength is spent. But David recognizes, or the psalmist recognizes here in this prayer, that God is always going to be there and to be willing to help whenever he is needed and be there to support and encourage. And even the psalmist understands that God is doing that even when the psalmist may not want it or realize it or recognize it. And so in Psalm 71, we'll see a testimony of the glory and the majesty of God in the lives of his people. And I want you to think about your own life as a testimony to the goodness and grace of our Lord in heaven today and every day, regardless of what stage you are in your life. Psalm 71, in you, O Lord, do I take refuge. Let me never be put to shame. In your righteousness, deliver me and rescue me. Incline your ear to me and save me. Be to me a rock of refuge, to which I may continually come. You have given the command to save me, for you are my rock and my fortress. Rescue me, O God, from the hand of the wicked, from the grasp of the unjust and the cruel man. For you, O Lord, are my hope, my trust, O Lord, from my youth. Upon you have I leaned from before my birth. You are he who took me from my mother's womb. My praise is continually of you. I have been as a portent to many, but you are my strong refuge. My mouth is filled with your praise and with your glory all the day. Do not cast me off in time of old age. Forsake me not when my strength is spent. For my enemies speak concerning me. Those who watch for my life consult together and say, God has forsaken him. Pursue and seize him. For there is none to deliver him. But, O God, be not far from me. O my God, make haste to help me. May my accusers be put to shame and consumed. With scorn and disgrace may they be covered, who seek my hurt. But I will hope continually, and I will praise you yet more and more. My mouth will tell of your righteous acts, of your deeds of salvation all the day, for their number is past my knowledge. With the mighty deeds of the Lord God will I come. I will remind them of your righteousness, yours alone. O God, from my youth you have taught me, and I still proclaim your wondrous deeds. So even to old age and gray hairs, O God, do not forsake me until I proclaim your might to another generation, your power to all those to come. Your righteousness, O God, reaches to the heavens. You have done great and wonderful things. O God, who is like you? You who have made me see many troubles and calamities will revive me yet again. From the depths of the earth you will bring me up again. You will increase my greatness and comfort me again. I will also praise you with the harp for your faithfulness, O my God. I will sing praises to you with the lyre, O Holy One of Israel. My lips will shout for joy when I sing praises to you. My soul also you have redeemed. My tongue will talk of your righteousness and your help all the day long, for they have been put to shame and disappointed who sought to do me hurt. God is a great and wonderful God who cares for his people all the days of their lives. I hope you know that today. God bless you. Take care. I'll see you tomorrow.
There's a peace I've come to know, though my heart and flesh may fail. There's an anchor for my soul. I can say it is well.